there are a lot of parents who are asking questions about the side effect profile of the available mRNA vaccines in children and adolescents. And I think it's a good question. What we know now in Ontario is that adolescents in general have fewer side effects to the mRNA vaccines than any other age group so far, which is very reassuring. A lot of these side effects are mild and nonspecific, such as headache, feeling tired, feeling a little bit under the weather, and these almost universally go away very, very quickly. What is more common in teenagers as compared to older people is heart inflammation. Now, this occurs somewhere between 1 in 5,000 to 1 in 10,000 teenagers who get the mRNA vaccine, which is, you know, quite rare, but does occur. So the vast majority of side effects in teenagers does not result in a need to see a physician or other healthcare worker and does not result in hospitalization. I think it is very likely that a COVID vaccine will produce more benefit than harm in the vast majority of children and teenagers. Severe disease is rare in pediatric age groups from COVID, but it does happen. As well, there are other post-infectious problems like multisystem inflammatory syndrome, which can be very severe and often require hospitalization. As well, the side effect profile of the COVID vaccines is quite good, with serious side effects only happening very rarely. For all these reasons, I think that the COVID vaccine would be a good idea for the vast majority of Ontario's children and teenagers. The safety process for the development and the evaluation of vaccines is more stringent, more protocolized than for just about any other medication. I truly believe that vaccines are about the safest intervention that current medical science has. And we've already had hundreds of millions of people across the world immunized with these vaccines. So I would say that we have a very good idea what the safety profile is. And for that reason, I would say that, again, getting a vaccine is probably the safer choice for the vast majority of our children. What I've said before and what I will continue to say is that even though severe COVID-19 disease is rare, it can happen. And so I think there are lots of children and families out there who are keen to get vaccinated because they think that's the safer choice. And I think that's a good reason to get vaccinated. I think there's a lot of children and families out there who aren't necessarily worried about the child themselves getting sick, but are worried about more fragile friends and family members, such as elderly people living within the household or immunocompromised people within the household or at school. And I think that's also a very good choice for children who are thinking about getting vaccinated or not. Finally, I think there are a lot of kids out there who just want to go about their daily lives without missing school or other activities. And I think, you know, getting a COVID-19 vaccine for that reason is a safe and responsible choice. I think the vast majority of parents who are skeptical are just trying to do the best they can for their families and for their children, and I think that's laudable. I would encourage them to seek out information at trusted, reliable sources like their family physician or from websites from reputable sources such as kidshealthfirst.ca, which is put out by the Ontario COVID-19 vaccine table, or the information that's put out by their local public health unit. Finally, there is an information hotline in Ontario that can be called by parents or children who have questions about the vaccine. So I think always trying to get more information is a great idea.